Hello, my name is Keith Williams. I've just had the wonderful experience of going on an honor flight. I've put together a little video slideshow here to show you and others about some of the things that we saw in Washington, D.C. on that flight. This is family rated, so your kids and grandkids just might learn something that's useful in their schoolwork by watching it. The flight I went on was the 31st that the Eastern Iowa Honor Flight Organization has put on, and they do a wonderful job of it. I'd like to introduce our group to you. The fellow in the white hat there is Gary Thomas. Gary and I were classmates at Lime Springs High School, graduating in 1955. The fellow to the right is Gary's guardian and his son, Ty Thomas. I'm the guy next to Gary in the red shirt, and next to me is Ty's wife, Donna Thomas. She was my guardian, and a very good guardian she was. Next is a picture with the Washington Monument in the background, and our group was joined there by Soldier Mac, who is part of the ceremonial organization based at Fort Myers. The picture with all the gold dots, which are really stars, are stars representing 100 American soldiers, airmen or sailors that died in World War II. This is part of the World War II memorial. A good picture of the Thomas family is next. And then we went to the FDR memorial, which I didn't even know existed. So that was quite an extensive memorial, and we were told that it takes 7.5 acres. There you see Gary and his friend Franklin standing there, followed by Mrs. Roosevelt, Eleanor Roosevelt. From the FDR memorial, we could see the Jefferson Memorial across the water. It was quite a ways across there. The next stop was at the memorial honoring the Korean veterans. It was quite interesting and very, very different. The white or silver-looking soldiers appeared to be rising up out of the greenery there. And you can see the amazing detail in the close-up picture there. The black wall over there is a wall of reflection, which has some very good photos on it. On our way to the Vietnam Memorial, the bus stopped near the reflecting pool. Looking off to the right, you can see the Washington Monument, and to the right of it, low down, is our nation's capital. And if you would turn around and look to the left, you would see the Lincoln Memorial. On the short hike to the Vietnam Memorial Wall, we saw the statues of these three soldiers. They were done in great, great detail. If you look over in the green there, the black sloping thing is the Vietnamese Memorial Wall. It was quite impressive, and it's quite long. When we got to it, we found that out. Gary and I are looking at the wall for our names, and we are both very, very thankful that we didn't find our names there. Next on our agenda was a trip to Arlington National Cemetery. This cemetery is 644 acres, which is roughly a square mile in size. It's very hilly and very beautiful. If you look off to the right, you can see horses pulling a caisson from or to one of the 30 burials that they perform each day at the cemetery. Then the Tomb of the Unknowns by the amphitheater there was quite impressive. In fact, this was the most impressive event, at least to me. I'll show two videos. The first of the honor guard marching his post. The second of the first part of the changing of the guard ceremony. Unfortunately, something happened to my camera and I missed the last half. I'll not disrupt the solemnity of this event by speaking.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? I am Staff Sergeant Courtney of the 3rd Infantry Regiment, United States Army. Guard of Honor, two of the unknown soldier. The ceremony that you are about to witness is the changing of the guard. In keeping with the dignity of this ceremony, it is requested that everyone remain silent and standing. Thank you.
The next monument is in Rosslyn, Virginia, the home of a lot of the defense contractors' Washington headquarters. There's a lot of very nice, very expensive-looking, very large buildings. I remember seeing one that said Boeing on and a few others that I recognized, but don't remember what they were now. Here we found the Marine Memorial, which I call the Iwo Jima Memorial, or the Iwo Jima Monument. As you can see, there's a great deal of detail in that memorial also, which is really pretty neat. Ty Thomas was a Marine, so this is sort of his memorial, but in more ways than one. I believe he and Donna's son was also a Marine, and Donna's father was a Marine. So this is a very special monument to the Thomases. Lastly, we visited the U.S. Air Force Memorial. Is there a reason it was left till last? Gary is a retired military man, having served in the Navy, the Army, and the Army Reserve. He's retired, but he never served in the Air Force, as I did. So I'm sure it was tough for him to stand with me before the statues of the Air Force Army Guard, but I appreciated it. The memorial itself, or the monument, is quite simple. Just three spires reaching high into the air, simulating, I suppose, three jets during a burst in the air. That concludes the tour of Washington, D.C. On the bus ride back to the airport, we went right past the Pentagon, where the scars of 9/11 were still visible. Once at the airport, we had a dinner in the lounge at the gate and boarded the airplane. On the plane, we were, each veteran was given a bag with a beautiful plaque in it commemorating the day, a letter from Senator Ernst, and a discharge certificate for the day's duties. The next thing was mail call. There was quite a package of mail for many of the people there. I got a lot of very, very delightful letters from friends and neighbors, which I really appreciate and was surprised to receive. Probably most importantly, there were pictures and letters from school kids. That tells me that some teachers are teaching the important things of our history, about our wars and our veterans and so on. So to those, I say keep up the good work. The real excitement happened when we arrived back at the gate in Cedar Rapids. The jetway was lined with uniformed officials, or uniformed officers, I should say, and other people. At least three Iowa Highway patrolmen, policemen, firefighters, and so on and so forth, all there not to arrest us, but to shake our hands and welcome us home. And once we got into the airport itself, we're greeted by the New Horizons Band and hundreds, if not thousands, of well-wishers. A lot of my neighbors were there, and eventually I found my wife there, and a lot of good friends were there. So that was the first time, and no doubt the last time, I will ever have been treated like and felt like a rock star. And it didn't even end at the airport. When I got home, my driveway had been decorated by our across-the-street neighbor, Karen, who does such lovely things for the neighborhood. And I would also, at this time, really like to express my appreciation and thank you to the Honor Flight volunteers. They really worked to make every moment enjoyable and perfect for the veterans. Their dedication was astounding. Gary and I would both like to thank Ty and Donna for looking after us throughout the day. They did great duty. And now for the commercial. If you're a veteran and haven't been on an honor flight, I would really urge you to go. That would be your special day. Just go to, on the internet, go to eihonorflight.org. And if you're not too savvy with computers, have your grandkids or your great-grandkids get it for you. That will give you all the information you need to sign up and get the ball rolling so that you can have as special of a day as Gary and I had. A lot of people took pictures here. Here are the main ones. And if you have watched this on YouTube, I would appreciate it if you'd subscribe to my channel. I only need 950 more subscribers. So thank you very much for watching.